Let's talk about text editing. Click to select a topic and just start typing to replace the text on a topic. You can easily see which topic you are editing because it has a red border around it. If you want to insert text partway along a topic, you can click a selected topic and you'll be put into editing mode with the cursor at the point where you clicked. If you want to edit just using the keyboard and want to edit the existing text, select the topic and press F2, and then use the arrow keys to position the cursor where you want and edit from there. You can also double-click to select a word, or triple-click to select a whole paragraph. When you have finished editing a topic, just press Enter to finish editing. If you are editing and you want to insert a new paragraph, press Ctrl-Enter. And if you want to just insert a new line in the same paragraph, press Shift-Enter. The text formatting options are available on the Home tab of the ribbon bar, but also if you have text selected, a formatting palette is available just above the text to make it easier to access the formatting options wherever you are. With most themes, the default coloring for text is automatic. Automatic text sets its color automatically to the foreground or background color from the selected color set and chooses the color which gives the greatest visual contrast to the background that it's drawn over. For instance, if the foreground and background colors in the color set are black and white, which is usually the case, then if you have a topic that's filled with a dark color, the text will automatically be drawn white, and if your topic is filled with a light color, then your text color will automatically be black. But of course you have the option to select any other color you want. If you are using a specified color and want to change any text to be automatic coloring, just select it and you'll see the automatic coloring option there in the color selection panel for you to choose. There is the ability to add as many hyperlinks to any topic as you like, and that is the recommended way of using hyperlinks. But if you want to add a hyperlink within the text of your topic, you can do this too. Just select the text you want to have hyperlinked and use the hyperlink button on the Home tab of the ribbon bar and enter the URL of the place you want to link to. Often you'll need to add more information than you would have just within the keywords on the topic, and this is done using the topic notes. You enter the notes by selecting a single topic on the mind map and displaying the notes sidebar panel. The same editing options are available in the notes as for the topic text.